just shows you how much all of us have achieved.
Very exciting.
Having fun, meeting new people.
I'm good and I'm happy.
I'm happy that I get really excited and I'm hyper.
Well, I've been doing this for over 30 years and this is just a passion that I have, seeing the athletes grow.
Is the crowd and amazing support and amazing teams.
A group of people who are supporting inclusion and acceptance through sports. Special Olympics. The Special Olympics USA Games here in Seattle continue strong, from the opening ceremonies on Sunday to the competition going on all throughout the week.
So there you have it. Lots of energy, lots of positivity, lots of satisfaction in seeing these special athletes have those big smiles on their faces.
Go Team AZ!
Yeah!
I'm excited, and this is my first time to the USA Games, too! And staying in a dorm up here in the beautiful Seattle, Washington.
But it all began with the opening ceremonies. Walking into Husky Stadium as thousands of people cheer while Arizona's Special Olympics delegation soaks in the moment.
I'm excited, and this is my first time to the USA Games, too.
Team Arizona's Martha Barasi was so excited, she couldn't help but start dancing as the opening ceremonies continued strong.
It's fun.
Fun for CDO grad Jimmy Kiwis as the proud Tucsonan and his Arizona teammates were grinning, spinning, and kicking as the theme rang loud and clear, a Special Olympics message of acceptance and inclusion through sport.
To have our players from Tucson make the Team Arizona to come up here and play in Seattle, it feels good.
Oh, yeah.
And even before the opening ceremonies, all the players and athletes from Team Arizona and the coaches as well made their way in parade fashion to the stadium, and they were greeted by lots of people cheering for them.
It's very exciting because we get to trade pins with the other teams. We get to meet the different teams from the different states.
Who will be competing this week. But before the games, it is all about sports goodwill, cheering along, and yes, even more dancing and dazzling the crowd, representing the crazy AZ as good sportsmanship goes round and round. Speaking of round, I'm about to round off my day with 60-degree weather right here in Seattle while back in Tucson, still pushing over 100 degrees. But hey, gotta love it. And the players, of course, they get to play in this weather. So fun about being in Seattle?
Competing in Special Olympics.
What would you like to say to a lot of the organizers and volunteers and coaches there?
I would like to tell them thank you for everything.
I'm really excited and just, it's pretty fun. It's just working hard for almost a year.
What did you like most about
Seattle? Just everything, the track. The track was pretty nice, and running, it was pretty comfortable, and it was like making me feel relaxed.
It's a good chance to make a bunch of new friends and be able to scope out the competition too, you know?
Yeah.
So for my events and stuff.
So Special Olympics for some of these athletes is that's what they do. Most of your athletes can't join regular teams because of their disability, but they love sports and they love going and playing the sports and being part of a team to where, and their families are like, oh, my, didn't ever know my kid was going to be able to do this, and this is a way for them to do that, and every kid deserves a chance to play sports, and no matter what, so.
Go Team SD!
When you go on trips, you meet new people that you don't know, that you never met before.
I'm really excited because I've been swimming for like 7 months. I mean, thanks to Coach and Vajra and everybody here, so thank you so much.
Describe what you like the most about Seattle.
It's beautiful. It was hot. It was hot in Phoenix, and now it's cool here. It's nice, it's beautiful weather. I tell them thank you so much for all the work I got the work all done for me. So
go Team Arizona.
Go Team Arizona.
It means I'm just not just representing for myself. I'm just representing for everyone who stands for Special Olympics and showing them that there is hope that you can get and far in your own career, your own ways, and your own sports.
Yeah, that's very cool. I've been working with the athletes now for almost 9 years in Special Olympics, and getting to see them compete and move up, and you know, just representing Arizona and going to the national games and seeing the pride that these guys are going to take with them, and then the level of competition is going to be just tremendous. It's my first time to get to go too, so I'm pretty excited about it myself.
Have fun, and they have good sportsmanship.
What did it feel like to win a silver medal?
Feels great. It was fun to work with the team, and it was fun to be here.
What did you like most about the Special Olympics here in Seattle?
Is the crowd and amazing support and amazing teams.
What type of pride do you have to be from Arizona?
Is that we came with honor and we're proud to win second.
Started like at our first practice, you know, we didn't know each other, and growing together as like a family, making friendships and relationships with people that I didn't know before. And winning with them, even though we lost, you know, this last game, it's just an honor to be playing with them because we mesh so well together. And we just work so good together. We cheer each other on, even when we mess up. It's always such a great honor to play with them, even though we took a loss today. It's great to see everybody come out and just support everybody, cheering us on, cheering every team on, not just one team. We don't have, you know, favorites or anything. We just cheer everybody on no matter what.
Awesome.
Go Team Arizona.
What's it mean for you to play a part in inclusion and acceptance as a unified partner with some of the special?
Well, my little brother has Down syndrome, and if he were to be on this team and he were to have partners, you know, helping him out, it's just something that, like, I would want to do for other people's relatives, you know.
What makes you so happy to be here in Seattle?
Because my daddy, my aunt.
What'd you like most about Seattle?
You know, the fun atmosphere.
I just love working with these athletes because they bring so much joy into my life. And I got, throughout the years, connected to them, and now we're a team and we just got silver medal. Woo.
What's it mean for you to help put smiles on a lot of these athletes' faces through your, you know, silver medal?
Well, it means a lot to me because I love spreading the positivity to other players and myself, of course. And now, since they're all happy and we got silver.
Well, this year we have the largest Team Arizona we've ever had with 137 people. And so I think having training camp is really important just to bring everyone together and allow everybody to meet each other. We have athletes and partners and coaches from all over the state representing us. And so this weekend was really just about bringing everyone together so that they would have the opportunity to get to know each other.
It's been actually like a really great honor to work with these kids and play alongside with them. I've seen them grow so much, just mentally and physically. And it's just wonderful just to see that growth in them.
Describe how exciting it is to be able to play in the special.
It's exciting for me. It just shows you how much all of us have achieved. Everyone here, every single team, they have strived to get better. Just so, not just for themselves, but for their family and friends that are watching, waiting for them to return home.
High five, baby, high five. Heck yeah. All right.
I've been coaching Special Olympics for 31 years. But for Team Arizona, this is our third big national tournament that we've been to.
And then describe how exciting it was to win the gold medal.
It was pretty amazing. That whole experience was incredible. Best experience of my life.
We are here in Seattle at the Special Olympics USA Games, and I'm with the Team Arizona softball squad who just won a silver medal. How's it feel, guys? Yeah! AZ! Okay, now let me take this opportunity to talk to Coach Sable. And Coach, talk about how excited you are about this and your team.
It was great. It was very exciting. Everybody played with their hearts and played hard, and I'm extremely proud.
All right, this guy's a big man, and he's a big man on the field as well. Describe what it means for you to win that silver medal.
It means a lot to me. I got on base almost every single time with an almost perfect batting average. I only got out a couple times. So pretty much that's all.
That's you individually, but you also got a silver as a team, yeah. My friend. All right. Yeah. And how about Jose? All right, this guy right here, he's been with the team for a long time, and now you got yourself a silver medal, yep. My friend.
Yeah, I'm just happy at least we got something for trying. We tried our best.
Yeah, just a silver medal. That's nothing, right? All right. And, of course, I want to say that this team is comprised of a lot of people from all parts of Arizona. Also, as a Tucson affiliate, we want to give props to the Tucson teams. We have Tucson High, Sunnyside graduates here. We have Rincon High represented. And we also have CDO as well and all of the Phoenix area as well. So good to see Team Arizona bringing home that silver medal once again. Let's do it, guys. 1, 2, 3, Team AZ. 1, 2, 3, Team AZ! Reporting from the Special Olympics USA Games in Seattle, Paul Cicala, News 4, Tucson.
Never. done something like this before. Well, I played on some travel team in other sports, but not like this before.
A lot of these guys work in around town and everything, and so a lot of their employers or co-workers and stuff have an opportunity to see them excelling at a level some might not expect that they do, that they could.
What's it mean to have this family atmosphere here?
It means a lot because we have each other to support on and cheer on, and we're here, we're all having fun, enjoying the time together. It's very special to be able to have this time with the family, even more that we're all together.
Okay, to have my family is very important to me because of more of support, and like not just physical, just emotionally as well. It's like if I'm down, I have them to pick me up as well. And then for my extended family, you don't even know. They bring so much joy into my life. They make me smile. They pick me up when I'm down, and they're just here to support everybody as well.
It was great. The best part was seeing some of the people who participate in other sports that I play softball with in the regular Special Olympics events here in Arizona.
To get on this team, you had to try out. It wasn't, you weren't just placed on it. And from there was tryouts from throughout the state. And there was 9 players that would have been taken, and 7 of them made the team that had been there before. So they play at a real high level. To realize you're playing on a national stage like that is pretty special. And I couldn't be prouder of these guys. I've known most of these guys since they were 10, 11 years old playing ball. And, you know, they got to this point with a lot of work, and they love the game.
Go Arizona and go Duck!
It's just totally cool. I was out there practicing with them yesterday, just shagging balls where they were hitting, and you know, these guys are pretty into it. They're intense, and they're wanting to take that level of competition and their abilities and show the United States what they can do.
The mission of Special Olympics is to bring is to provide year-round sports and training opportunities in a variety of Olympic-type sports for people with intellectual disabilities. And specifically in Arizona, our vision is to promote inclusion through unified sports, which combines individuals with and without intellectual disabilities on teams together. And really, the guiding principle behind that is, you know, sports is a universal language that breaks down barriers naturally, and it allows everybody an opportunity to participate, to be on a team, to be a part of something bigger than themselves, and to have an opportunity to excel in athletics at an elevated competition, at an elevated level, very, very competitive, and really give them an arena to shine and to show what they can do and their abilities.
What does Special Olympics Arizona mean to you?
Special Olympics Arizona, to me, means family, I think. Because I think even though it's only been a year of playing volleyball with them, I feel like we've grown so much as a family and as friends that I'll always remember this forever.
Thanks to my career and everything, and thanks for supporting me, and great life, and yeah.
I think it means sportsmanship and determination. Like, we couldn't get here without, like, us just wanting to play and wanting to play basketball because we love the sport. And yeah, like, it's so cool to be able to do what I want to do.
It's a bigger family. Better friends. I'm not saying better friends, I'm saying like
these people respect. And family, as younger kids, you gotta teach them. We're teaching each other here, you know? And we're a family, we respect each other. We gotta teach each other, and that's the way I see it.
I haven't been in this Special Olympic family that long. This is only my second year, and I'm just really grateful because being put in this family, and now I'm a member for life.
Man, I look back, and it's just showing how much we grew as a team. Now we are here in Seattle in 2018, and I'm just so excited to be here.
Take a little trip and see. Now who wants to take a trip?
Arizona!
Take a ride through the AZ side.
The Unified Team players are proud to represent both the city of Tucson and Marana as a whole right here in Seattle. And the Special Olympics players and partners, they represent everything from North Pima County to Mountain View High School to going way back to Tortolita Middle School. Let's reminisce. Check it out.
Tortolita Middle School!
5 years ago, number 22 here, Kylie Horn, and other current players on Team Arizona's Unified Basketball Squad hooped it up in the Special Olympics for Tortolita Middle School. And now they've matured into a team comprised mostly of the city of Marana and Mountain View High School players gunning for a medal at the USA Games in Seattle.
I find it to be such a big honor because from here I was actually able to see how they grew, and so many of them have grown so much, and it makes me really happy for them.
Happy because as a unified player, Kylie's able to truly spread the message of acceptance and inclusion through sports, something Joshua Strubring appreciates.
It just shows you how much all of us have achieved. Everyone here, every single team.
Speaking of team, this is footage of another unified player, Ray Brennan, at Tortolita 5 years ago. And now with Mountain View and Team Arizona squad in Seattle.
We're a family, we respect each other. We gotta teach each other. That's the way I see it.
Brianna Labor also sees it and feels the family connection in Marana.
Go Marana!
And now, with her teammates in Seattle's USA Games, who suited up alongside of her 5 years ago with Tortolita.
It was so exciting. I loved it so much.
Man, I look back, it's just shown how much we grow.
Going full circle with the Special Olympics motto, still going strong.
But if I cannot win,
let me be brave in the experience.
Go Team AZ. Speaking of the crazy AZ, a team from Tucson that consists of players from Sunnyside, Desert View, CDO, and Tucson High, just to name a few, are gunning for a medal in softball. I'll introduce you to them on Tuesday night on News 4 Tucson at 10 p.m. Reporting from the campus of the University of Washington, Paul Cicala, News 4, Tucson. The Special Olympics USA Games here in Seattle continue strong, from the opening ceremonies on Sunday to the competition going on all throughout the week. There's lots of Tucson ties right here in the Pacific Northwest. Arizona squad of Special Olympic athletes all know as teammates, they're like family, but in this case, it's true.
We are AZ!
All six seen here from the Arizona softball squad at the USA Games are related, whether it be siblings, mom, son, or husband and wife. Meet the Parran Mesa family of Tucson.
It means a lot because we have each other to support on and cheer on, and we're here. We're all having fun.
Fun. For Ruben and Javier Parra and their nephew Anselmo Mesa, who all suit up as Special Olympic athletes. While Tatiana Duchesne, Ruben's wife, keeps stats for the team, and mother Grace Mesa and son Eduardo are assistant coaches.
I'm very happy they pick my family to go to Seattle. I'm very happy.
Apart from Seattle, Ruben and Javier suited up on the Team USA softball squad that won a gold medal at the World Games in LA.
Woo! It was nice. It was cool. Yeah. It was so fun.
But they take more pride in representing Tucson and their roots in the Sunnyside District.
Let's go, come on, let's go.
In fact, there's a bit of a Southside school rivalry in the family, with three going to Sunnyside and two from Desert View. So as volunteers with the Special Olympics and a DV graduate myself, I knew I had to join in too on the sibling Sunnyside unified rivalry. And after all that, I still couldn't trick Ruben into falling for my trick.
Let me hear you say, go Desert View.
Go Sunnyside.
I almost got you.
Hey, all joking aside, we truly are a united family. Not just from Sunnyside or from Tucson, but a group of people who are supporting inclusion and acceptance through sports. Special Olympics. Reporting from Seattle, Washington, Paul Cicala, News 4, Tucson. Here at the Special Olympics USA Games in the Seattle area, there's a lot of downtime in between competition and games, but one thing's for sure, there's lots to do. A lot of the players from Team Arizona are doing anything from hiking around campus to trying some of the local eateries to fishing as well. Yes, there's a lake right next to campus. For now, with the Special Olympics, it's all about doing a little fishing as well, especially for the basketball team from Marana. Mountain View High's Leo Bohorquez always has his game face on when he's shooting hoops. And the same goes for fishing, as he and his teammates at the Special Olympics USA Games can attest.
I asked my mom to bring my fishing poles, and she did. So I brought my fishing poles out here. Me, Raymond, Kenyon, and Shania came all out here to fish.
Yes, in between games, they've been hitting up Union Bay alongside the University of Washington, a short block from their dorms.
What I think it is, it's fun, honestly, to have friends that could fish and have their own fish poles come during weeks and games. Like today, we had a rough day at a game.
So they cleared that stress away by casting away and getting in some fishing.
Have you caught anything yet?
We've caught a bunch of seaweed.
But no fish.
Not this particular day, but the group of proud Marana residents already have plans to hit up the lake once again after their next basketball game at the Special Olympics USA Games. And oh yeah, even though it's the University of Washington campus,
U of A.
They made sure to mark their territory.
U of A.
By claiming U of A.
U of A.
In Washington Huskies territory.
U of A. U of A.
Bear down for what?
Go Wildcats. Go U of A. Bear down right on the campus of the University of Washington. And also, we will continue to cover all the teams from Arizona with Team Arizona at the Special Olympics USA Games right here in Seattle. Reporting lakeside on the campus of the University of Washington, Paul Cicala, News 4, Tucson. But it all began with the opening ceremonies. Walking into Husky Stadium as thousands of people cheer while Arizona's Special Olympics delegation soaks in the moment.
I'm excited, and this is my first time to the USA Games, too.
Team Arizona's Martha Barisi was so excited, she couldn't help but start dancing as the opening ceremonies continued strong.
It's fun.
Fun for CDO grad Jimmy Kiwis, as the proud Tucsonan and his Arizona teammates were grinning, spinning, and kicking as the theme rang loud and clear, a Special Olympics message of acceptance and inclusion through sport.
Have our players from Tucson make the Team Arizona to come up here. Playing Seattle, it feels good.
Oh, yeah.
And even before the opening ceremonies, all the players and athletes from Team Arizona and the coaches as well made their way in parade fashion to the stadium. And they were greeted by lots of people cheering for them.
It's very exciting because we get to trade pins with the other teams. We get to meet the different teams from the different states.
Who will be competing this week. But before the games, it is all about sports goodwill, cheering along, and yes, even more dancing and dazzling the crowd, representing the Crazy AZ as good sportsmanship goes round and round. Speaking of round, I'm about to round off my day with 60-degree weather right here in Seattle while back in Tucson, still pushing over 100 degrees. But hey, gotta love it. And the players, of course, they get to play in this weather. Reporting from the Seattle area, Paul Cicala, News 4, Tucson. Hey, thanks a lot there, Matt. The Special Olympics at USA Games in Seattle are just over a month away, and dozens of athletes from right here in the Tucson area will be representing Team Arizona. The group of Special Olympics athletes were treated to a big surprise at their recent team-building camp in Heber, Arizona. Had the honor of being there in the Mogollon Rim area of Arizona to capture this. Hugs, high fives, and huge medals. Not just Special Olympics medals, but these Team USA women's hockey medals sported by Arizona native Lindsay Fry as she spoke to over 150 athletes, coaches, and support staff from Team Arizona in the Special Olympics.
I mean, they're an inspiration to me, so this is awesome.
Lindsay Fry was part of the silver medal squad at the 2014 Olympics in Sochi.
I remember there was a time when leading up to the Olympics, I was so stressed out about making the team. I just kind of lost sight of what sports is all about. And we went and hung out with a bunch of Special Olympians, and they were just having fun and working hard. So to be here with them, to kind of give back what they gave to me, is just the best feeling in the world.
The feeling of elation, excitement, and inspiration, fulfilling the mission of providing opportunities for sports to scores of special athletes with intellectual disabilities through competition.
I do track and field, and I'm going to bring home the gold.
No doubt, Martha Barrasi was one of many special athletes thrilled to meet Lindsay Fry.
And just meeting one of the actual athletes is awesome. And I just called my parents and gave them the news, and they were all totally awesome, man.
Awesome, concentrating on preps for the Special Olympics USA Games in Seattle. The opening ceremonies for the Special Olympics National Games in Seattle begins on July 1st, but the training is year-round, and a lot of that training ends up with many players from Tucson and some of the other athletes that represent Southern Arizona right here in Central Arizona. It's a special team building camp in the Mogollon Rim, Central Arizona. We're about 30 miles away from Sholo, and one thing's for sure, the team building continues strong, and those dreams of winning a gold medal, or any medal for that matter, continues as well right here in the Crazy AZ. And Team Arizona includes a softball squad with over a dozen from Tucson who already won gold at the Special Olympics World Games in LA.
And we're really, really excited to watch them fight for the gold.
The same goes for a basketball squad of Special Olympians from Marana and Mountain View representing Team Arizona.
Go USA!
And go Team Arizona!
Team Arizona!
As we go for the gold and give a gracious thanks to an Olympian who also has our backs. Oh,
thank you!
Hey, through my involvement volunteering with the Special Olympics, I have the tremendous honor of being part of the Team Arizona support staff for the USA Games in Seattle. So look forward to more Special Olympic stories with Tucson athletes from the games themselves come July. Hey, we're far from over with. After the break, we will head to the NCAA Golf Championships where the U of A continues on its Cinderella run. Could they continue to stun the competition in Oklahoma and advance to the championship? More sports, more energy, more golf madness after the break. How's your energy, Southern Arizona? Good evening to you. I'm Paul Cicala. Ari Alexander has the night off. And what a spectacular day it was at Amphi High School. We are talking the Special Olympics track and field competition, from the athletes parading onto the track, Olympic style, to the law enforcement torch run, to the lighting of the flame. These are some of the sights and sounds and athletes that truly make the Special Olympics just that, special.
Set.
Dozens of years and running.
Special Olympics Southern Arizona has been helping athletes achieve their dreams through multiple sports. And in this case, it's the 2017 Special Olympics Coronado Area Track and Field Competition. Over 605 Special Olympic athletes representing 28 teams, schools, and organizations from all of Southern Arizona had a day of fun, fitness, and friendly fighting for first. And in the case of Troy Ahai's Andres Gonzalez, a bronze medal would do just fine.
Not fine.
Little Andres is just one of hundreds of athletes benefiting from such a worthy cause.
How's the Special Olympics for you?
Awesome.
And that deserves a high five. And it's definitely something to smile about.
I had the honor of emceeing the opening ceremonies of the Special Olympics this morning, and hey, I got to see those smiles firsthand, up close, personal, never gets old. Congrats once again to all the athletes.